I'd like to play a little 3-bet here. A little 3-buy. What are you playing during breakfast? J4. Gute Besserung, man. 7 o'clock in Germany. Time for Bolero stream. Well, not bad, obviously. Gonna perform much better on the spot than he does. I actually think he's a regular, not looking at his stats. I like another small bet here on the turn. Just put on the ball, more pressure on. Fold that ace, queen, ace, check, king, jack of diamonds. Build a pot in case we make the... I won't say nuts, because he could have ace four. But he called pretty quickly on the turn, so yeah. Easy jam. Good run out. I would prefer like a non-ace on the river, I guess, but that's the fine. Hey. People just don't give me credit. At all. I love it. I mean, people give me a shit ton of credit for finding bluffs there. So yeah, I definitely love it. It's cool. Easy. Obviously, winning quite wide here with him in the big blind. Good booty. Now we're just gambling for it all. Probably running to a check here a decent amount of the time, but yeah. 8 or 3 is all we need. And he'll probably flats wide as well. There's the 8. Goodbye, guys. 1 out of 10. Let's get the W. That was pretty easy. That's funny. I mean, the hands kind of played themselves, I would say. I like the lines I took. It's nice to run good as well. Yeah, just gotta check here. I think this is not a bot, I bet. I mean, I can bet it sometimes. We shouldn't bet it that often. Turns also time to check. I'm just gonna bet. Nice. Sure. Too easy, 5 me. Ace 9. Not much he can do. We could have gotten an extra street by betting flop, but I think I want to protect my checking range a bit more by checking 10-9 there as well. I don't think it's an unreasonable flat pre-flop as well. I'm just going to lead out here. And take it down. It's a nice spot to overbluff versus what I would assume slightly weaker opponents. Could obviously, versus regular, I wouldn't lead there. Bounty too small to do anything. Man, I picked up a nice bounty there. That's so funny how pure that was. It was just like 2 clean hands, easy game. Alright, he's going ham now. He's not happy after the king 6 hand, I gotta say. He's not happy. 8! Alright, FT bubble. Lego. Oh, we're also down to 18, the big 27. I'm 8th place of 18 remaining. Gang shit. It's a certain Twitch streamer, I would say. I'm just going for the C-bet. I'm going to be over C-betting the spot, I think, but it's fine. I don't think we have particularly much fold equity in the turn, so I like just checking and hitting the flush on the river. But never ever lucky. So I just think we just give up here. Can't really rep that much with a bet check bet line, because I had some weak ace axe, so... They saw me bluffing with the king 6 before, so I'm just gonna take it a little easier. I realized at midnight I missed the knights and caps game. Yeah, it's amazing time for me here to watch all of that stuff. I only miss it when I forget about it. Hey, flop another straight. Not the nuts anymore. Still a very good hand. Let's fire again. I see a lot of fools here, I guess, on the turn. Yeah. Can't do much. Gotta go for value. Consistency, do as I say, not as I do. Yeah, I think that argument never makes much sense, right? Just you can be an expert on something. Like you can be a great football coach and be totally overweight and don't have much many football skills, right? You can be a great marketing analyst without actually ever being this like working in the space yourself. As like an influencer or whatever. I think consistency really helps you stream in the beginning, but I'm not consistent right now. Path into ASMR. Path exposed? I mean, Path talks about it on stream, otherwise I wouldn't tell you guys about it. It's not like a bad thing to be into ASMR, I guess. It's a bit funny, but whatever gets you off, right? If he bets river, I don't see myself folding, really. 3-4, 3-5. Yeah, we should win here. Majority of the time. That's nice. Maybe we should value bet that river, to be honest. I'm just worried he has a deuce or some shit. We should probably value bet King Jack. This is party caption. Used it for the first time today. I like it. You just bet call on the flop here. Hope he has 7-8, 7-5. Queen 9. So we have an all in on the call. Queen 10 versus Queen check. And we're on the final table. And we get a fold, which is fine with me. Final table in the Bounty Hunter. Second try on party. 1 of 8. Good chip lead. Let's get it. Always lucky. Confirmed. Booty booty rocking everywhere. Fun hands. Lots of new faces here, I like. So yeah, we're on the final table, guaranteed 118 on top of our $300 bounty. So like 500 bucks, first base is, I think over 2K total. Cool. Let's get the payouts on the screen. I always put the wrong thing in there with party. Let's fold this here. Actually, before I put the payouts properly in there, I'm just gonna get some information on these guys. It could be a regular, could be a recreational. I kind of have to say, I would just go with the recreational tech. Dunno. King 7. Gotta call it MBB. Club. Jack. Never lucky. Oh, that's that guy. Let's see. Guess regular. It's always tough to know in party, man. Certainly regular. This guy seems also like a regular. He's really short now. Alright. Let's put the payouts in the right spot and then have a look at Twitch chat again. Gen Z. I'm gonna open this chip leader Lero, queen through zero, Kyle. I mean, I'm here to play some poker, not to fucking fold. 1-3 bet. I mean, obviously not great table position with this guy to my immediate left. But yeah. How can I download this run good exe by not complaining and firing up a session for 11 hours every day? And then running good in one of the tournaments at some point. What's the red number? Not sure which red number you're referring to. Oh, this is the amount of big blinds I have. How do you meet Path and the other guys who live with you? Like, Twitch poker is like not that huge for your community, right? So we were just talking. Oh, fuck, I should call. Actually, I should. It's fine. Wait 1 second, let me put on the light and we'll answer. Yeah, Twitch poker is just a small community, right? And you and I talk a lot with the other guys, and so I know Pat for like 2.5 years. We pretty much started at the same time, so we were chatting occasionally, hanging out in each other's streams. Same with like Travis, aka Tremadegen, and yeah, Egyptian just got added in there as well. I'm gonna open the ace-8 here. Less to play against him. I don't really remember when the game started. I was just mid-grind, so it's tough for me to pay attention to things. I always forget about things because I'm just grinding. We all in here. He can have some traps here, some ace checks, but that's okay, we're gonna suck out. Yeah, that's a trap. It's obviously a pretty bad setup as well. Yeah, really reasonable trap there with aces. Great time from the DSA side. I have ace 8 mid round dead as well. Yeah, just gonna go for another open here. I like it. Good spot to trap. And the only thing we could do is like call and then fold to regem as well, but it's like 28 BB, you know. Pretty good turn. Actually, I don't even hate an overbet here. I'm just gonna go with the 70 as well. 4 or 9 is what we need here. All right. Usual spot to get raised. Interesting spot to jam. Playing was a dude with 88, 65 stats, 54% 3 bad. I had a similar dude, man. I was so sick. Thought he yes, man. Cheers, Luxstream, thanks. It's the craziest guy I've ever seen. I had one guy like that where I was like, I think like that's not even that many people that punt as hard as people like. Same guy you're referring to. It's the first guy I noticed it where I was like, man, this guy's just like so out of line. The thing is, when you're multi-tabling, you also don't realize it. And after a while, I was like, what the fuck, man? This guy's insane. I just looked up ASMR. What the fuck? Yeah, it's pretty odd, but I mean, there's something for you. Go ahead. Not a bad hand 3-bet, but I have like a pretty spewy image here. Oh, we can come along. Pretty good board for his range. Not that bad for mine either. Might do something if he checks it here. So we're throwing chips now. Speed up a little bit of chips there with the ace 8. Don't have to do that, but that's not that unreasonable. We are down to 14 players in the big 27. 8 of 14. Let's get to the final table there. Yeah, big blind stat is that one. So it just says I have 61.92 big blinds. How does nobody come up with the idea that it might be big blinds? I mean, this is not that tough to figure out. It just makes it easier when you're multi-tabling to immediately see how many chips you have. Yeah, exactly. There we go. Yeah, it's kind of fucked. I'm not sure why it's not working properly right now. Is it effective big blinds? I guess effective big blinds could make sense. But then it should only change on a KO, right? I'm confused right now. Sure. Given the speed, he checked it as well. Usually we don't see that many Queen X. Nice. Yeah, now I have 65 big blinds. It's just my big blind amount. That's the first day I used this, guys, okay. But it's just the amount of big blinds I have. And now I paid the ante, so it's only 64.96. Is it really like that tough? You guys got me. Like, I was worried there for a second. Like, I'm missing something here. So I guess it's just a little bit buggy when it goes down to like when the hand is new dealt. But this is like the number that matters, obviously. Cheers. Milk on the screen. Got the queens and the big blind. Bam, bam. Down 12 now. Guaranteed $115. Woo! Gamba, gamba. Hold. Nice. Oh, when we see a 4-bet jam. No call. Who farts the most? Probably me. I don't know. Do you watch a video of you that I put in Discord? No, I didn't. I saw it was a random video, but I played too many tables today to focus on like Discord. Wait, let me open it up. Oh, you posted that. I thought Mirko posted it. Fuck. What the fuck is this? Holy shit, the amount of this size is insane. Yeah, okay. Oh, mega lol. I'll be three-handed. Oh, I should probably update the title to find a table. I think I forgot that. There we go. Bet or check, both reasonable. He flats so much in a small blind, so like that's kind of what I like about betting here. Yeah, makes betting a bit more attractive. That's like a better structured small blind range. I guess you want to check this more often because he has like the better 10x at a higher frequency. But when he flats more, he's gonna have more a6 off, a5 off here that continues. Gonna check back turn and call most rivers. Yeah, not my favorite river, but just got a call with like 7-8 breaking, 7-9, 9-8, all of that shit breaking. Versus check, I'm gonna value bet. Just trying to get value from 5 or like pocket 4 or something like that. Let's make it like half pottish. Don't think we'll check a queen too often. Or like ever. He could have like king 10, but even that he probably just block bets. So I feel pretty good about my hand here and hope to get a hero call. Not the case. We open the king queen. This guy has 3 BB. This guy's also pretty short. Definitely calling off a jam. King jack off, let's gamble. Might just bet calling the flop here because he's so few ace backs. I think so. Kind of sucks because occasionally he just has ace deuce and we're drawing dead. Yeah, like ace six. Jack. Never mind. I still think it's pretty reasonable, right? Like compared to the couple of asex that he has there, he has just more other hands. No, Pav is strict with that. I can't ask for unbans. No special treatment just because I know you. Actually, I don't even know you. Who are you? What are you doing in my chat? You want trouble? That's 40. All right. Into like I'm a bit out of. I mean, Queen 7 suited hijack. Yeah, it's not even that out of line, but maybe just slightly. Hey, I was chip leader there for a second. Oh, still chip leader. What up? All right, FT bubble in the big 27. That was a fun hand, man. With the king queen. No, if I win there was 8-9, nobody bets an eye, but now it's pretty damn funny. Oh shit, 6-8 gets in versus check 10-0. Oh. And we're on the fine table. Cool. So yeah, quickly get some info on these guys. It's also just a micro egg. I mean, come on, $4 EBI. What is this? I mean, this graph looks fucking amazing, but just saying, like $4 EBI. It's like, that's a good fine table to be on. Gotta say. Yeah, and he's just also, yeah, that's a good. Oh, we already see some action. Kings versus queens. 10. All right. Ah, okay, effective, I see. Yeah, it is effective big blinds. That makes sense. That's pretty awesome though. It's even better. It is effective big blinds, yeah, for sure. I mean I remember when I put it in, it says effective big blinds. I just forgot about it. No, it just shows like his stack right now, right? 43 big blinds is his stack right now. That's the one that matters. That's a great turn. Lots of great turns today. Just gonna lead here. All right. I used this lead as a bunch of as a bluff today. It's kind of fun to actually do it and then just get the fold as well. Yeah. You guys are right. So yeah, we guaranteed 150 bucks on this big 27 final table. It's actually a fairly deep stack besides this guy. Yeah, I mean, that looks pretty damn strong. Such a small 3-bet there. Just getting off the way with ace jack. You're not fooling me with your good hand. And we could call and always take it 3 ways, but ace jack off's not amazing, so. Staying out of trouble there with the fold. 6 out of 9 over there. Man, I should have set up another setting for the other final table so I could make it bigger as well. But I can just do that on stream right now. Let's see. Just like that, you know? Let's do that. So this is like, let me just do that. The preview, okay. Boom. It's really that simple. Professional streamer, man, just got the move, still got the moves. So there you go. Now we have both of the fine tables next to each other. Put the pairs over here. Oh shit, we have an all-in. Knights versus checks, he doubles. Sorry, boys. Professional streamer. Alright, we're all set up. Nice. Now I can quickly switch between the tables. You have nice looking teeth. Do you practice good dental hygiene? Yeah, I would say so. Brush my teeth twice a day, every day. Every single day. At least twice a day. There's no matter how drunk I am, I always brush my teeth. German call off, yeah. But just standard spot, I would say. Bad call standard, what the fuck? Yeah. Against a 13 big blind defending range. That's pretty standard. Yeah, Dijon has arrived a week ago. He needs a mic, so he's waiting for that and then he will stream again. Shade Frugalo. Boom. 100 and something bits. Cheers for that, mate. Thanks. Alright, we're gonna call this off. Hodel. Hey. Good hodel. We're down to 8. See if I can squeeze some payouts as well. No, he didn't. Yeah, just raising over his limp here. Definitely want to isolate him, take the pot heads up. He's gonna have a lot of ace X in his limp calling range, I would say. So I'm gonna stop the check. Hope we can see a turn. I think with the sizing, I'm just folding, to be honest. By the way, let me know which final table you want to see, if you want to see the 55 bounty. There's roughly the same amount at top, a bit more money up top here, and there's obviously bounties or the big 27. You won't miss a hand I'm playing, but just as a default. Thanks, Harry Bushman. No, I finished all the peanuts. There's knockout tournaments on ACR, but no PKOs. So they have like a, I think they have like a $55 knockout or something, but I never play those. I don't know. Check it. Unlike the open heeled showdown, but it's just not a really not a bar texture web bluff. You know, it's just not a bar texture. It's all always range. May have to hope to fold out something like fours through sevens if you flatted that preflop. Maybe like an 8-9 or check 10. It's just such a strong range, really. I don't particularly like it. Also, we have a pair. I could just bluff 4-5. The 3 doesn't matter. He has a blocker. Because they don't have two pairs with the 3, so. Yeah. FNC is pretty nice. I mean, lots of grinding for me personally. Just because this is the first time in my poker career that I'm grinding peak time. And it's amazing. I love it. So I've been grinding more than I expected to, just because, yeah, just so nice and not usual for me to play that many nice tournaments. Pocket eights. Let's see. Up for flat here and then a jam from sevens. Sixes, not sevens. Boat Lero. So this check 10 just rips it. No. Let me go for another one. Ah, so it's like 13 effective versus him and 56 versus him, right? This is insane. Such a cool display. Yeah. Awesome. That's so cool. Not sure where the 82 comes from right now, to be honest. 53 makes sense, obviously, but 82? Not sure. Yeah, I don't really get that one. Shit, the blue hero's back. What up? I mean, long grind for me today, man. We get almost 11 hours now. Over 10 and a half hours, at least. What's opening the up the ace 8 over here? Jack picked the flop, just king high, you know. Let's just fold to give up. Two guys with plenty of ace X in their range. This is just odd. This is probably just a fun player. Lots of flatting, lots of flatting. I don't even hate this as a c-bet, to be honest. I wouldn't bet much on this board, though. Two overcards. Block some ace 4, ace 5. Don't hate it. Alright. What if I had a turn like a king, a queen, an ace, a check, obviously, but just 9. Still ahead of some hands. But yeah. Occasionally, we could just chop it here on the river, or like win, but an ace 2, ace 3, you know? 6, 5 takes it down. I don't mind it. I think that's fine. Get a block with this one. Ooh, aces, 50 BB. Some shorties around. Hope we see an open and a jam. And then I hope he thinks I'm hunting the bounty or something. Let's see a flop with a queen 9. Not ideal. That's a large bet. Yeah, just takes it. Come on, some action with the aces. Monsieur! Oh. Didn't know it was still his turn. Alright, alright. Yeah, I mean, I'm giving... Oh my god! I mean, this is just like prime example of me playing great poker in this tournament, I gotta say. Oh, good luck, aces. So he trapped king's preflop and he thinks as well. Oh shit. That's unfortunate. He did trap king's preflop. Hey, we got the side pot though. That's something. That's something. Man, what's up with these fine tails? You lose queens to aces on the other one and no aces to kings? Ay, ay, ay. would have been a good part, but hey, I take a side bounty, you know. We don't lose that many chips, that's alright. Could have been much worse. Obviously, reasonable played by everyone around. Interesting. Bet call, check, lots of options. I think bet call is just fine with the gut shot. Checking back here is also reasonable. Right. This would have been nice. If I'm in the spot, I have a pretty big chip lead and can apply some additional pressure. Not that I'm not out of line already. okay. I mean, I'm gonna try. There's still just plenty of hands. I just want to fold the flop here. So why not? Hello! Let me fold, party. I'm a bit worried. Party just crashed on me the other day on the final table. Actually, yesterday that was. We have a pair. I would be in the mood for a pair right now, to be honest. I have to think about dinner. Cooked some bolognese yesterday. I mean, I guess I'm not playing. Oh my god. We're playing live poker tomorrow even. Oh shit, yeah, we're playing tomorrow evening. That means I'm gonna fire up a morning session. Yeah. Never mind. went for an open that I shouldn't. Oh shit, we have null in the call. 10-3 with the hero. What? Okay. I guess blind was blind, some hero call. Eh, that wasn't you. What? He just called down, like, what? Yeah, I don't have a regular streaming schedule anymore. Man, these guys are out of line with my 3 bet. Yeah, the check-in open is actually bad. As I said. Yeah. I don't have a regular streaming schedule right now, just because I love grinding so much, and I can't really stream when I'm grinding 15 tables, you know. So I wait till I have, like, deep runs, and then I fire up the stream, which is around this time of the day, maybe a bit earlier. Yo, cheers, Iprito. Man, happy to hear some feedback, man. Thank you for taking the time to send a message, man. Alright. Could go bigger as well. Just hope he has, I don't know, pocket hands and goes for it. Yeah, I mean, it's nice with my type of work. I can just travel the world while still doing my job, you know? That's what I'm doing right now, like, experience New Zealand, have a good time over here, and then once I'm done with that, I might be South America, Asia. Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, sure. Could happen, Kiplav. I'm not really sure right now about my future, to be honest. Like, I don't even have an apartment in the UK right now. Like, I'm totally free. I just have to see what I want to do. I love the UK, man. The people there are just amazing. The food in Edinburgh is nice. And it's just a beautiful city. I really like... I was a bit sad when I left to get here in the first place, just because that was the first time I was settled in. And I was, like, ready to just live in Edinburgh for a while. But it's always, like, I'm always in the mood for the last 3 years now. So it's almost longer than 3 years at this point. I don't know. At some point, I definitely want to settle in. Could be New Zealand, though, because it's really amazing over here. So we'll see what the future brings. Got a bad call. Hope he three bad jams a check. Three bad jams. Just three jams a check. If he folds, it's all right. At least we don't lose the hand. Man, 2.6 million. That's kind of the stack of for us here for most of this tournament. Yeah, I'm not really sure what a 77 is about right now. It's got me confused again. Yeah. Now, I could see myself, like, living in pretty much any country of this world, to be honest. As long as it has good internet. That's, like, the one big One big thing. If there's no great internet, I can't stay in the country for too long. I mean, definitely for half a year or something, but not forever. Oh my god, lol. Have you even caught the kings? That's pretty nice. Funny. Would have been too clean, right? If you went there and just have the infinite chip lead to get the bounty. We're still chilling in 8 of 8. I'm gonna be fairly tight in this pick 27. I was a bit too loose at the start of this final table. I'm gonna chill. Boop, 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 boop. Oh shit. Nein. Damn it. So in the two party FTs, aces versus kings versus ace queen suited, and the other checks versus queens versus aces. Thanks, Herc. Running so bad. When will it end, guys? When will it end? Yeah, the kids with the power. All right, see. I'm gonna see a flop here with the king queen. Highly unlikely that I won't see one. King Jack off regem. Huh. All right. Do-do-dim, ba-da-bum, ba-dum-da-dum. Just need a hand on this fine table and then get one double up and then be cruising. I mean, that counts for both white and Davis. Alright, let's go Queen 10. I'll just take a Queen 7-4 board, you know? 7-4 is in there. We have the 10 of diamonds. We can continue. Oh, that's a great turn. He doesn't see by that much. Yeah, Stitch just got a bet. I mean, he's gonna check back if, like, even 7x, he occasionally 4x, 2x. He has a pretty low c-bet. It's kind of nice. Good to play against. It's probably recreational at this point, to be honest. So, your WCP, yo, what up, Hotted? No. I'm new seeded, man, for the next couple of months, so won't take the time off to go through the WCP. Next year, next year. I really want to go this year. I have, like, a good amount of, like, I'm in the right place right now to go to the WCP. I have the money to afford it as well, and yeah, but just with New Zealand, I just can't justify it, man. It's too nice here. I don't want to go to over to Vegas. Yeah, but nah, next year. I mean, I said that last year, but I'm pretty sure I will go next year. I mean, I was like 90% sure I would go this year. That the entire New Zealand thing came up was obviously pretty spontaneous, and we only decided it's like 2 months or so before we actually went here, so we'll see. But good luck you for you out there, man. It's sick that you're out there. I'm following the trip, man. I follow you. I saw you and your dog over in Texas. You know, I'm up to date. Wanna see some bings, some winners pictures and shit. GLGM, mate. Alright, come on. Aces. Over here, this dude lost some chips. I mean, look at these stack sizes. 150, 130, 150, 130. Oh, he's also somewhat short. Yeah, we're just chilling. Give me them ladders. Still pay for the apartment in the UK. That was actually my plan, but we got kicked out of our apartment 3 days before I left for New Zealand. So I was like, ah. That actually works out pretty well. Put all of my stuff in storage unit. And yeah, now I'm actually homeless. Homeless Lero. BHG. Ah, the reason we got kicked out is not because it was like dirty or something like that. They just wanted to use the apartment for themselves. And you can't do that. And so we had to move out. And Yeah. It was actually not that bad of a time, you know. It was 3 days before my plane left, so it was a bit stressful there to get all my stuff wrapped up. Like I literally took like it was 3 days before my plane left to New Zealand where I had to pack up all of my stuff, my chair, my TV, my bed, my mattress, so many things. So yeah. But whatever, I'm gonna save a bunch of money now because I don't own an apartment right now. Or that I don't have to, since I don't have to pay rent for anything other than this place. I'm gonna check it back here. If he checks turn to me, I'm gonna just go for two streets. I really like the sizing. Makes me feel good about my ace check. Let's call. Some hands get there. Come on, just fire out like a quarter pot here or something. Yeah, I'm just gonna bet third. Hope we get called by the 10. Or Vika check. Alright. Over here, kind of interesting hand. This guy opens. He calls a small blind. I call as well. It's checked around the flop and checked around the turn. I decided to lead the turn here. Could go a bit smaller. I just want to protect my hand a little bit versus over cards. So he has to check here. I don't want to make him fold that. So I'm just giving up here. Hope he has maybe. I don't know. It's tough to win this one. Eight is also a river that just eliminates some bluffs, so we called it sizing, but nothing else. Oh, interesting. Interesting. $70 bounty, letters are fairly small. All right, never mind. Yeah, I don't like to lead with King 5 that much, but he leads a lot of his check acts, so I guess it's like not that awful. Ladder down to 5. Nah, non-showdown is always like. Minus, all good. Don't worry about that one. Yo, danke, FTVazy. Yeah, run good is alright. I mean, we lost the aces to kings on this fine table, which wasn't ideal, but V3 of 6, life's good, man. Can't complain. Yeah, stacks are fairly even between all of us. I mean, same over here. I mean, this guy's short, but as I said, lots of even stacks. So most of what's happening, yeah, I'm just gonna chill. As I said a couple of times now, I'm just repeating myself at this point. And this guy seems good. Put some pressure on me for my wide opens. Certainly punished me a couple of times now. But just queen it off with like it's just such a perfect position. It's recreational on button and big blind end. You know. It's pretty tempting to like 4-bet jam in this spot now, just given the momentum and how often he has been 3-betting me and everything. It's tough to say, you know. He hasn't been that out of line if you look at his stats. Just feels that way, but he hasn't been that out of line. I've been pretty out of line, so I probably should continue here in some way. If that's jamming or calling, I think both are pretty reasonable. Wait, he actually folded his king that spot? What the fuck? I thought you were trolling when you said that. That's a good turn. Maybe bad turn, I guess, versus his checking range. He's gonna have a lot of eight better ace x. It's not a board that he should bet too often, so I think he's gonna have a bunch of checks still on the flop. Yeah, I'm not loving it, but can't fold ace 10. Let's see what the river brings. He's always gonna check back ace king, ace queen here on the river. I'm just gonna go for small lead. Hope we get called by those hands. I really hope he just calls here. It's so disgusting if he jams. This is some street poker. He's in a time bank. It just looks weird on party. Just call. Ooh, if you fold ace king there, well, sick fold. Good run out. Don't they have to give you a heads up? That's messed up that they randomly kicked you out. No, it's like they had. They just gave us a heads up of 2 months, right? But my flight was already booked at that point, so I had 3 days to move all of my shit out because they obviously didn't know I was leaving for New Zealand. So it's not, yeah, they have like, it's 2 months. Like, in some apartments, even only a month. It's pretty fucked in the UK. Yeah, I mean, Dnex made some nice plus on the final table, but he does some plays that just show that he has like no idea what's going on. Like, c-betting ace queen on king king 8, calling a check raise from the big blind and then raising over his turn lead. He also likes to raise like in spots where his opponent has all the value range. He just re-raises another hand for value. And the thing is, he ran good with it twice, but if he ever runs into a good hand, he's just getting fucking stacked. Like, he raises in the spots where you should never ever re-raise, just because it doesn't make sense from a theoretical standpoint, given what your opponent's range looks like and what your hand looks like. You had a range, like either your opponent's bluffing or he's not, and then you raise your hand. This doesn't make sense. So I saw plays like that to just make it clear that Nicarano has some pretty big leaks in those regards, but I guess he has some live reads and he put out some nice random bluffs that worked out, so it's good for him. I'm absolutely not a fan of his playstyle though. Yeah, I think Bonomo is also not that great, to be honest. He's on a solid run, but I haven't seen anything from him while he was playing that I was particularly impressed by. It's fucking disgusting. Nah, I will never join Teams Poker Stars. Never ever. Honestly, I think I will just stay with Naturate for like a long time, I hope. If you find the next older and next younger of you, you don't have to listen to anyone else. Like, I don't want to make fun of your English, dude, but what the fuck are you even saying? Do you ever block by the check on the river like this? Maybe you think about jamming? Never ever. This is just purely exploitative ace 10, ace jack, I guess. Good luck here. Let's hope he has two random overcards that just fold. All right, good night, Mirko. Hey, that's awesome. Back over here, open king six on the button, check, check, flop, check, check, turn. I'm gonna find a little value bet in the river. No, like Henry Stein, obviously Henry is God. I am a God. I'm just betting. We could pick multiple sizing, depends if how much he's heroing. Just bet small. Because max EV, that's what it's all about. King checks suited, UGG opens, I flat the small blind, we flop two pair, nice. You have to stop multi-table and start to think of reposition. That's such a good comment, man. Like, the fuck is he even trying to say? And we lead fairly big. Nace is not really folding here, so could even pot it here. Dude, if he has sixes here, it's gonna be a Vietnam flashback for me. Yo, cheers, KB. Don't be arrogant, look at my graph. I'm always gonna be arrogant, but I'm in a position to be arrogant. You know, I'm a winner. I'm a machine, I'm the best. If you are the best, you're gonna be arrogant. It's not something you understand, Eastern, you will ever understand. But if you're just like some weak random dude on Twitch chat that tries to give me advice, I'm just gonna fucking destroy you because you're just not in the position to. Like, know your fucking place. Damn. $70 letter. Hey. Apparently somebody busted at some point. Oh shit. 10. Check. Hey. And King 10 versus 6 is Ripperino. Damn, he called an 80 big mid regen with King 10. Ambitious, but got it. Wow, that's awesome, Nico. So whatever the guy is, tell them the truth. I'm generally actually a fan of like telling the truth to people. Much better for your conscience. And at some point it's always coming out as well, so just be honest about things that you fucked up. No matter where you are, like, the worst thing is that it happens quite often. If you're in a new company and you fuck up in the beginning and you really revert about it, tell them about it. If it ever happens to you during, like, an apprenticeship, or not apprenticeship, like, how you call it? Like, a trial base, you know, when you do something for, like, a couple of weeks or 6 months to test if you like it or whatever. Whatever, if there's anything like that, you fuck up tremendously in an important spot, tell them about it. Nobody will mind. Shit happens. No matter how bad you think it is, tell them about it. You did crack. You fucked your boss. His wife, tell them about it. It's alright. Like, don't fucking lie. I don't really like this, honestly. He should bet at some point. I'm just gonna bet 70 and hope he calls. But I don't know, like, why is he checking flop? Why is he checking turn? Why is he checking the river? I don't know. Maybe he just said he's king. Yeah, I mean, I was obviously rooting really hard against DNX just because I dislike him. But yeah, it's good to have a villain in there as well, you know. It's quite easy to only have guys that you like. Many great players in there. And it's good to have some villains in there like Helmuth or Negreanu. Or Gary Katz. Not saying that he's like a bad guy or anything, but I mean... Just... Whatever. We should. I hope for a call. I mean, I take a fold as well if he's short, sure. Not sure what he's tanking with. Fours? Did he decide to bet on the flop? No idea. Ooh. Well, that's an interesting tank. Oh, shit. That's a fine 3-bet on the other table with a good hand. From the big blind versus button open. Yeah, I'm just gonna fire big on the flop jam turn here. Checks are quite vulnerable, you know. We could size down with hand like kings or aces, but so many bad turns like ace, king, queen, 10. So I'd rather just bet big, charge a 10 here, and then see about the turn. Thanks, Frederick. How you doing, man? So he does call. I mean, he's obviously he has some two pairs, some sets here, and then we just go broke. Shit happens, you know? But that's life. What would Henry leave Team Heart? Like, honestly... I mean, this is a great river, generally. He could have ace deuce. Might also just fall down the turn. Good luck. Oh shit, he's actually bluffing. That's cool. Not like I like that trade. Every time I interact with the guys, like even the people that I in the management and shit that I worked with, had dinner with. I like they're great people. They're just really nice people. And even like if you're in Macau, man, everybody likes the Natural 18 pros. Like everyone is just has fun at the table, you know. It's awesome. I like Asia. I'm a big fan of Asia now. Macau got me convinced. I'm happy to I'm proud to run around with the Natural 8 flag over there. So I'm the chip leader on this final table, and I'm 2 out of 7 on the other final table. I like where this is heading. Gotta give this guy hard for bluffing the 5-3 on the river. I mean, he obviously should fold flop. He should definitely fold turn, but it's fine, you know. He doesn't know that. He has the heart to go for the lead bluff on the river. You gotta respect it. I like it. Yeah, let's just check here. We should probably bluff you, to be honest. We should definitely bluff you. Never mind. I kind of misread the situation a little bit. Just gonna try to fold out like 9x and 7x, but it's too recreational, so I'm just gonna give up. I'm just gonna give up. Oops, sorry for that. Yeah, I'll definitely up the aggression a little bit now. I want to win a bounty tournament party. Actually, I won one like a week ago, but yesterday we got second, and that was annoying. I wasn't happy with that, so want to get the win today. Be in a nice position with 63 BB versus a bunch of 40 to 50 BB de stacks. There's another big pot bla being played over here. I mean, Spike Aces is always in there. Like Henry might turn to McGregor. Oh shit, ace 3 is just punting off really hard. Okay, we call it 3-bet. Actually, he's been really passive. Makes the 3-bet. I just want to play pots, you know? Like, I just want to play post flop against these guys. I gotta see a turn here. Let's see that check roll off. That's a pretty good turn. It's a pretty good turn. Seems highly unlikely for bluff bet, or like bet bluff the turn here. So we see a little give up here. Just knock the table. Pocket checks might be good at showdown against my tens. Pocket checks might be good. Damn it. Yeah, I'm not having this. He 3-bets me pre-flop. Really small, I call. He bets flop. Just gonna give him a little raise. Dude, I don't have all day. The people want to see the other fine table. Like, you know, you call 3-bets with Queen Deuce, you raise the flop. It's just, it's street poker mixed with GTO poker. It's just. Like, people just. Like, come on, like, don't 3-bet me less than 3x and don't come in with, like, a quarter pot bet on the spot texture. Just don't, you know? Just don't. Thanks, Julian. How you doing, man? I'm just gonna check here. Yeah, fuck your boss's wife, time about him, lol, best advice I've ever heard. Man, every time I come with some life advice, I always end up in a trolley way. But I think like it's generally important just to be honest about things you fucked up. We'll save you lots of trouble. I'm gonna go for a C bet. We can C bet fold 5-7 here, you know, it's not the worst. Oh, tempting turn to jam. Tempting turn to jam. Yeah, we gotta go for it. So PD folds 3-4. Ace 4 with the ace of diamonds. You know, those type of hands we're targeting here. If he calls with the 3, you have plenty of outs. Worst case scenario, you have 6 outs. Or 7 outs, I guess. Woo! Ace not suited, let's call. Good flop. Can check raise, can check call. That's a good turn. Gonna just check call. Bluff poke jam. I mean, that was a big hard bluff there. And we bet the river and just hope he calls with sevens. Kind of tough to get called there. Some big ace, whatever. What do you think about a bluff jam with the river off and the paired river, Henry? Not GTO. Alright. Good. Exams and streams are live these weeks. You good? Good luck with the exams. Yeah, I'm great, man. Never felt better. Thanks, Danny Ivy. I'm just gonna take showdown ready with the fives. Okay. That's the minimum once again. Also chip lean in the big 27 now. I'm gonna flip the button here with the 9-7. I'm really happy with my queen to suited play there. That just shows that my exploitive play has improved like tremendously. I've done races like that and bullshit like that like more and more now against recreationals, and it's just something that makes me pretty proud to see. A good flop over here. Don't really want to bet. There's better hands out there. We give them an opportunity to bluff. Just gonna keep the pot a little bit small. Obviously aggressive open from every position, but I'm chip leaning this now, and I want to rule this fire table. Okay, so I'm gonna take over. He has quite a wide range, I would say. The bets the flop. He's still like a bunch of queen check, queen nine, check nine. He in the big blind has 8x flush draws. Obviously, river I like a block bet. Just gonna charge some 8x that he might have bet on the flop. Same counts for him. Some weaker 10x. Just better like than checking and not really knowing where I am against recreationals once again. I mean, this guy seems like a regular, by the way. I just hope he has like the 10-9 here. Yeah, we should mostly win against that calling range, to be honest. Yeah, don't get that. Why are you not just betting the turn? Bono was the best. Certainly outplayed Vogelsang really hard there with his ace 10 against his kings. Yeah, I'm just not a big Bono fan. This is when it's a little part here. Man, long day of grinding. Hey, what up, Steven? And said, Steve-o. And so you're seeing pretty good so far. Had a 30k month. Over 30k profit this month. Weather is good. Life's good. House is nice. Setup is good. Lots of good things. This guy's just a bit out of line, you know. Just got a 3-bet here. And time to the 6 on the final table. He rips it. Heard on Mr. Blue Hero. Just like das Quarterpot Bullshit Sizing, just like on board textures, so that's like not a thing. I'm not having it. Especially when he comes up with like whatever small blind 3-bet percentage is. 37% small blind 3-bet, you know? Yeah, I guess we start with the bet. Modest Henry. To the moon. Nah. Do you want to bluff him off an ace? I guess occasionally we have like 0% chance actually. But then again, it's just, it's a bit ambitious, I feel, to try to make an ace fold here against a guy that I don't have much information of. Like a recreation, I could easily just have ace deuce here, ace check, and it's like, ah, I'm not folding, you know? So I think I'm just giving up. Obviously, an awful turn. I flatted this open here with ace 10. Gonna call this c-bet on the flop. Didn't win a 1-9 pico yesterday. I got pretty unfortunate heads up a couple of times and finished second. Not in love with this. Not in love with this. Not in love with it. Just check it back, Luxrin. Just check it back. Just check it back. Don't do this to me. Don't make me fold ace 10 on the river, dude. Don't make me do it. I guess he makes me do it. Too bad. There's no one in the UK about you. What? What are you trying to say, my friend? I don't understand. I only speak German and English and French and Latin, and you are not speaking any of those four languages. Cheers, Frederick. Yeah, I'm definitely enjoying myself. Here she goes. A nice little walk. Sticking around here. Yeah. Should definitely start applying some pressure. And that pressure. My favorite flop to bet. Check it. If he checks it to me on the turn, though, yeah. 70% Lero. Oh, see, limbs at 4x, he calls. Check, check, flop. Fire turn, win it. Delayed c-bets, boys. You don't always just have to fire the flop if you don't want to. There's always the opportunity to do better turn. Say Bonomo as well. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. Just whatever. Fucking Bonomo. It starts with the name. I wouldn't say I'm particularly excited about the World Cup. It's kind of a nice time, so you know, I can get up in the morning, have some breakfast, and then watch the World Cup. The guys might join in as well. Yeah. I would say Germany are still the favorites. The team isn't as good as like 4 years ago, but still. Pretty nice. Not a big fan either. I prefer Chitwick or Mateos. Yeah, what up, Heisenberg? Yeah, I love watching Chitwick play. He just plays like great poker, great confidence at the table. Super fun for me to watch. I obviously like the people I love watching the most are obviously all of the Germans, and then and Chitwick. It's pretty much like yeah, all the Germans and Chitwick and Prince Kenny, just because he's a gangster. You know, I just really like the math oriented style that some Germans play. I love the exploitative style that people like Goose play. Steffen, that is. I love like Christoph, really analytical, slow. It's interesting to me. And like Prin is just fucking crazy. I like that as well, pretty creative. I just don't enjoy many of the American rags just because they, I don't know, I just never really enjoyed watching them too much. We're gonna c bet a queen 9 here. Just gonna fold out some random stuff. 8 9 7 8 ace, some ace x that full turn when I bet the flop. Over here, I decided to limp this the cutoff with the queen jack suited. I just didn't really want to raise fold, so thought I would keep the pot a little bit smaller by just limping. He's in the tank now. Just let it go. Comes in with the raise. I take down with the queen high on the flop. Probably was the best hand. Wow, we have a close spot here with King Jack on the FT. I think I'm just jamming this pre-flop. With a decent cutoff range and a really wide button range. Alright, let's hope we can hold. Alright. They figured out pretty well. I think it's a really reasonable rejam. Obviously, to run. Dude, this is ace check, which sucks, but he doesn't have many other hands besides ace check to dominate me in that spot. Actually, ace check is the only hand, right? Ace check and king queen. Versus all the other hands that he calls there, and then versus the opening range, obviously, we're also performing pretty well. It's kind of unfortunate to run these hands. Pretty fortunate we actually win. It's been tight. I just can't fold ace nine. I just can't. Hard! Thank you very much. We're three-handed now. He likes the king jack off rejam, goes for it himself. Well played. I like it. Alright, just like that. We three-handed. We finally have the stack I should have had. We held with our aces. So let's get that fucking win, guys. Got a chip lead. Let's put some pressure on. Let's have some fun here. Three-handed, as we see an all-in on the other fine table. Queens versus ace three. He just won't stop. Let's see a flop here. Yeah, there's gonna be lots of flops played over here. I hope we can finish this one quick. Yeah, there was like this Bonomo multi-accounting online thing. I only read about it briefly, so I didn't really know what exactly happened there, so I don't really want to get into it because I just don't know. We have kings versus sevens. Oh, and there's pre-flop all in, and both of them flop a set. It's not a cooler or anything, they just got it in pre-flop. I'm gonna go down on my knees for a little bit just because my back hurts, I have to say. The desk, like the tables are a bit low right now. I would have loved to jam then, just take it heads up here, but obviously slowly grind him down is fine with me as well. Decent flop. Discipline forward with the ace-10 big blind, but hard to find enough bluffs. Exactly. Yeah, it's just all about discipline folds, otherwise you can't make deep runs. I'm not sure why I'm laughing at everything I'm saying. I'm not even high or anything, guys. I don't know. It's just been a long session. So open queen 10, small blind and big blind continue. I see about the flop, and it's a good outcome when the big blind calls and you'd hit the queen on the turn. Does he never have worse ace x there? No. I think he might bet them smaller or something. Like if he bets the third pot, I'd probably call ace 10, but if he jams there, I think he's polarized towards the flush. Bet ace x, some boats. So over here, I raise this king blind versus blind, bet the flop, he calls. I'm gonna bet the turn. And take it on again. 7 million now. Pretty good chip lead. I'm gonna be ace 10 versus checks. Let's watch this first. That's a KO. I'm gonna be fairly aggressive here. Just see how they play back. He's been not that aggressive from the small blind yet, so maybe he can get away with it. Guaranteed 363 on the other final table now. And pocket ace is a good hand. So if you see an open and a jam, that was the opposite. Maybe a bit too greedy on mine to ask for that much. Three betting over here with the 10-7 suited. Check 7, limp pot. Definitely want to complete the small blind C flop. Yeah, pot definitely has some weird blind levels. Not enough frequency. It's not about frequency in that spot, right? I mean, I guess it's the sandbox hand, but I just don't think he would do it with like ace 10. What did he fold there? That's really important to know. An ace. All right. If he folded like a suited ace there, it would be pretty nice. Just gonna c bet here. He's probably overfolding his flop. I'm gonna check the turn here. That's a good river. Damn it. ambitious float on his end. Yeah, let's finish this. Just gonna 3x the small blind. He folded a bunch in the past when I 3x, so I'm just gonna continue with that. Let's see if you can't just blind him down. Yeah, my hotkeys are a bit fucked today, so I hope I wasn't on the wrong table. Christoph is really impressive, yeah. Yeah, he took a dirty beat against Bonomo, obviously, that was sad. And he's just such a nice guy. Yeah, I think giving up there was a small blind in the spot texture is totally reasonable. Not a good hand, the big blind. I've gotten many walks so far, not this time around. Ooh. I mean, I ain't folding pocket nines, guys. Wow, that's a small 3, right? 360. Wow, that's a small 3 bet. Alright, I'm folding nines. Wow. That's a small 3 bet. Oh, we see the 4 bet click. Let's see what happens here. I don't know much about Fabian. He hasn't been in the scene much over the last years. At least I haven't seen him, so can't say anything. Might have been good in the past. He comes in with the flat. Oh, we're getting 3-bet over here. I think he threw me a couple of times now. But yeah, I'm just going to see a flop with the 9s and, you know, go from there. He takes so long to act for a reason. He obviously tries to be balanced in his timings, which makes a lot of sense. He also thinks everything through. Got a call here. And we see an all-in over here. So he had ace-9, he had kings. Could have been much worse for me. So we call a c-bet, hope he just gives up. 8-9-0, easy jam. And check, and hope he just checks back the river here, even though the king has a good card for him to bluff. Let's check it. Yeah, too bad. He gets it. Over here, I open the button, I check the flop, I'm gonna bluff turn now. We're gonna bet pretty big here on the river. We need to fold out ace-x here, and I want to make clear that I'm not going for the chop here. I have ace-king and I want to get value from ace-4 here. And you obviously see there's like some occasion 7x and check-x. Wow. Usually a spot to get raised. Too bad. Oh shit. Nope, he just folds. I'm going to raise here with ace-9 with the limp. King-4, we obviously continue. That's an ugly turn. yeah, just checking river and hope he checks it back with checks of hearts and clubs. Hey. Well, here, as I said, I erased over Slim and bet small on the flop. Lots of his range just missed that board. He had fives, okay. Seems reasonable. I'm gonna call here. Hope he just gives up now. Probably have to fold ace 9 on the turn to that sizing. I have like a bunch of low garbage to erase the preflop. Easy jam with ace 4 for like 8 BB. And gonna raise ace 9. Hope he reships the weak ace. Just gonna bet small again. He likes floating wide as we saw with the queen 9 earlier. So, yeah. Just betting ace high because he has a bunch of weaker hands. Let's see a flop here. Not ideal. Just gonna give this one up. Can't do much with the 2s 8. I mean, his bounty is also not big. Oh, is he going in? All right, let's get him. 5. Ah, damn it. Oh, he waited. He waited a long time. He had got his king. That's reasonable. He likes betting flops. We should do something with the backdoor clubs there. Let's just call here. Obviously, it's a bit of nice. Like, I have to consider ISM as well. I don't really want to bust before that guy. He's obviously a really wide button range on the spot. Means he's going to break the spot quite often. I'm going to just continue my king jack here. Hope he just shuts down on the turn. He does not. Gonna continue the king 10 here. Well, not continue. I'm gonna see flop with the king 10. Oh, ace 5. We're here. I'm definitely opening. Thanks, Ace Merc. I think Party Poker is the toughest side out of all of the sides, to be honest. It's a nice spot for him to bluff. I often have just ace highs. What up, Tim and Sad? How are you doing? I feel great. I hope we can win this one. And win this one as well. Alright, if you reach us, we're calling, guys. Let's fade a jack. Nice. So we got another KO. Now we heads up on this one for around 2k. So I had some in the 55 bounty and 2-6 in the other one. I'm really happy with my heads up play. So let's hope this one works out for us. Can check the flop or bet. I'm not sure, man. He's some type of weird regular, I feel. I'm gonna try to implement a somewhat exploitive strategy. Oh shit, we're dropping frames. That was weird. Hello, frames. Please come back. Gonna call these high. That's too bad. Just got through a call here. Now, given the amount of hands I see bet on the flop, I think ace check should just always be a call block and queen check and king jack. It's open for an 8-7, 8-6, 6-7 type hand. Missed flush draw. Gonna continue with the queen 4. See a turn. Got some connectivity with the 4 of spades here. Like that. I'm living in Auckland, New Zealand right now. And I think I will just take my showdown value with queen high here. And over here we call 3 with 6-5. Wow. Take it, my friend. Gotcha. That's a great turn to bluff. Let's do that. Lots of ace, king, ace, queen that just have to mark it here. Alright. It's nice to get that bluff through. Well, here I open 10-9. He calls. I check the flop and bluff the turn. We get it through. That's nice. Situation with Nature in New Zealand, can you play or will you be able to do it? Yeah, I can play. I played on there already. I already won a tournament on there. I won the green 120 for like 1500 the other day. That was nice. Your path is the host. I don't like it. Too early, mate. Too early. Wish me luck on this FT. And on this FT. What up, guys? Cool that I get a host from path. That's fun. So yeah, he's on the next door. Obviously, we're on the final table of the big 27 with 1600 up top and heads up in the bounty under 55 at 2K up top. Just trying to finish the session real strong here. And hope we get hero called here because we have a little chip deficit. And I already finished second in a bounty tournament on Party Poker yesterday. So if today comes better, thanks for the host path. Welcome, everyone. 5 minute delay today. So try to finish first place in both of these tournaments. Sorry for that. So this is a limp pot this time around. Unusual to see limp heads up at the stack depth. Yeah, we'll definitely play the 2K main, and if I don't run deep in the 2K main, I'm gonna play the 5K high roller as well in the casino. So limp's ace 9 off, interesting. Path busted, lol. Seems like it. Ripperino. Swallowed some chunk here. He likes floating, so I'm just gonna double barrel here, even though I don't really have a good hand for it, to be honest. Oh shit, we see a 3-bet jam on this flop. Eights versus king, queen. Sick. Chips are evening out a little bit. See if he can... Whoa, he just jams turn, alright. Henry with the out-of-line double barrel gets punished. Alright. I think it's pretty reasonable against him. He continues lots of hands. That is a small bet. If I had an overcard, I would do something about it. That's gonna open the king 8 suit over here. Have to call the big blind if he jams. Yeah, just gonna bet really small here. Just 10k and then fold if he jams. You just wanna fold out things that like hands that don't have a club in them. Nice. He limps, I have 24 BB. I'm just gonna rejam ace it off. Which doesn't perform that well post flop. And I'm gonna continue raising. He hasn't been 3-betting me much, so I think raising is superior to limping from my point of view, so, like, for me. Alright, let's see, flop here. That's a good flop. I like it. Just one double up and be back in the mix here. Actually, I'm just gonna... let's wait for the raises. It's a bit surprised that party's the toughest side. Well, I mean... They're acting like they're the new poker stars, right? They try to get all the regulars on their side, and that's working out with good promotion, lots of rake back, and therefore it becomes a tough side. How much you up? This month is like 30k profit. East King over here. Like over 30k profit, I don't know by how much. Something between 30 and 40k. We hope... That none of these guys, that he doesn't rejam here. That's nice to see. Good luck, Ace King. Sadly flipping. Luckily, German. Goodbye. Alright, five handed now. Guaranteed 490. Finding a big one on the turn here. And checking the river. And winning. He jams 5 BBs, and I'm calling it off with Ace 4. He's ace queen, but luckily German, and we hit a 5. Or a 3. Not cool. Check it off with the open. Just gonna go with the C bet. Because I have the check of hearts, and mine's sizing a little bit smaller than the 8 also. Like, there's not that many bad turns as if I had ace check there, you know? Ace check of clubs or something. So we both on new path up 30k each. Could be. I don't know how much path is up. He's up heaps as well. Feeling pretty good about my Ducey. Lul. 10-8 suited we open and ace queen we open. And c-bet. This guy's a bit crazy. Just gonna check back the ace queen and bink a check, hopefully. That's a good river. Let's just check it down. Nice. Doesn't even bluff the 9-7 on turn there. Lovely. Just lovely. Well, it's pretty interesting right now. The three of us have really, really close, like really close in chips, right? And this guy's much shorter. Dude, this guy plays really fast. Is this guy a bot? Like, is this guy a bot? He might be a bot. I'm just throwing this out there right now. He's probably not a bot, but there's just some things that didn't, like, he's so quick with his checks. Before the chips are even dealt, he already checks. I don't know. Oh, a little suspicious. All right. Limp pot, check, check, flop. He bets turn, I call, and the river's a king. Hopefully he doesn't have check 10. That's a small bet. Gotta raise over that bet. Every now and then we're gonna get caught by a better hand. Most of the time by a worse hand, so that's nice. Good luck. So let's hope he has, I know, some king jack, king 10 type hand that calls here. Alright, I take a fold as well. We had a chip leader in the big risk. 27 with 5 left. Yay. Dude, look at these bets. They're so quick. It's insane. Love your stream, mate. I've learned a ton from your stream over the past year or so. Cheers, man. Happy to hear that. Oh, shit. He punts it off with queen 10. I mean, he's really short. Not really a punt. He's D-bets. We continue with the 5-6. Great turn. Should slow him down pretty often when he's bluff, or if he's bluffing here. And I think I'll just like a little block bet on the river here. Just make 200k. Whoa, a little bit of value. Feels good, man. Stacks are evening out. He snap calls ace 9. Pretty reasonable. Feels good. Pat didn't grind today. He's in the casino playing a live tournament today. Over here, open king for suited in the hijack. Gonna check back the flop. Not quite the turn you want to see when you check it back. Because obviously when I check back the flop, I have plenty of check X. So I'm just checking it back again and then calling every river. If he checks, I would fire. Yeah, pretty easy call now. And we lose the minimum against king 5. That's also pretty good. Oh, a little bit of a big flop bet by him. Still going to continue with my gut shot. Hope he just slows down on this turn. I have a double gutter now. Oh, man, there. But can't really continue. Too bad. Over here, we defend the big one with the 8-6. Any bets? And I'm gonna see a turn. Yeah, I'm in New Zealand now. I'm streaming during a different time of the day, guys. I started my grind 12 hours ago, okay? So I'm 12 hours into my grind, just streaming the last 3 hours of it or whatever. Alright, take it back, my friend. And these limbs are quick. Oh, he's gonna bet here. 100k, snap, boom. Yeah, we're gonna raise him this time. He's gonna have so much. Just complete air balls here that fold. There we go. We're evening out, man. Like, we're closing in on the stacks. Feel like I've got a solid read on this fella. Yo, what up?
How you doing?
DD joining us.
Are we doing okay? You
yeah, sure, sure. I'm just heads up, so can't really talk much.
Oh, yeah.
Because heads up is like about momentum. Yeah, gotta be in the flow for that one. Gonna check it back again and go for some river value here. I gotta fold here. Yeah, just gonna throw in a little third. I think a call by 9 on 8. He's queen on the FT now. I'm fine as a flat or a 3-bet.
Yeah, if I'm messing with your vibe, you just let me know.
Nah, totally fine.
Big deal, I don't take it personally.
Call or raise, both are fine. I think I like calling because he's just a bunch of weaker queen X that I want to continue and not really push out. And over here, he has a missed straight draw every time, right? No, queen 7. Okay, that's interesting. That's good to know. Obviously, pretty bad turn, but when he checks, I feel really good about my hand. I'm still going for value. He should just have a bunch of weaker queen X here. Just some complete air balls, some like 9s with a spade. Ooh, a check jam. That's not a thing that happens. He's a massive punter. That's one thing I know. I saw some pretty absurd punts from him in these spots. Quite an annoying situation. Makes my bet much worse if you get check jammed on here, but it really doesn't happen that often. I think I'm still folding, just the situation with ICM is pretty terrible. Interesting Jack Jam there on the turn. Yeah, we saw him punt earlier. Just unusual, right? Like, if he picks up a gacha there on the turn or whatever, an open ender, he usually just continues barreling. So I'm a bit surprised there to see a check jam. I like it, honestly. Punished me hard for my screen bet there, but yeah, just a fold. It's fine. Okay. Just had to recall something here. And yeah, we got a clear river bluff here. Just going to fight 2/3 in there. Represent the 6-7, the 4-5, the 8-5. Check X. Bot is calculating. I think he's a bot, by the way. Calls queen 4. Bit ambitious. I don't think I have that many bluffs in that spot, but obviously fine. Not a great bot for my 10-3. I'll check it back. And I'm going to raise and just punt off here. He's done a lot of these leads with just garbage and like draws himself. So don't hate, just bluffing here. He limps so quickly, it's unreal.
You said you think he's a bot?
Yeah, it's so weird. Like, look how quickly he limps. Like, I don't think he's a bot, but I just have no idea how a human would hit the limp button so quickly before the... like, he limps before the blinds are even dealt. It's pretty absurd. It's been really tight with... his three bets, so I don't hate folding this. Yeah, I'm giving him a little raise here on the river. Hope we get hero by a king, even though I don't think he has that match very often, but it's just close to impossible for me to lose here, so I want to raise my ace. Oh, fucking tilting, man. He probably bluffed this twice now.
What a psycho.
Yeah, he's definitely a psycho. Gotta check it back here. And this time we're just calling. That's an awesome river. A lot of people expected to see about your flush draw, so this is a great river for him to bluff it. Obviously he has 5x as well, some two pairs. So I'm just gonna jam here and hope we get heroed. Good luck, guys. Nice, here's the 5.
Easy, easy.
Awesome run out.
Done, sir.
Mm-hmm. Nice little flop check there. And then the great river. Back to even and the heads up. This is what I mean. Do you see how quick he raised? Mm-hmm. It's insane. It's, I don't know. It's just weird to me. Maybe just 3-bet calling 7, see if I have a few BB. Good luck. It's pretty nice. Nice. Nice! Let's fucking go.
Attaboy. Easy peasy. He snapped that off too, huh?
Yeah, pretty reasonable for the jam with fives.
How many big blinds?
Like 50. Hot. Nope. Alright, we got a good chip lead now. Let's hope we can close it out, guys. 120 BB. I'm gonna start limping more, obviously, at this SPR. Nice flop. Over here, I opened the button with ace 9 suited, got 2 calls. Kind of interesting board. Where's the lead? I'm just gonna raise stack off. It's not great with ICM. The thing is, like, actually, nah, we can just call. Never mind. Change my mind there. Because I was like, he's going to 3-bet jam check 10 every time, but we don't know that, so calling makes more sense. And we just hit the club on the river and live a good life ever after. That's also a really good river. He's just going to slow down now with like a lot of check 10, 10, 9, check 9, and we just win. It's obviously fucking disgusting. Let's quickly go over here because he c-bets, and I'm just going to raise stack off top pair for 20 BB deep. Good luck. And that's the win.
GG.
There we fucking go. There we fucking go. Finally won a bounty 2.2k.
Easy.
Pretty tilting river here. It's just... it's tough to fold getting these odds. People usually don't bluff the check 10, 10, 9 like that, but occasionally I do, and I think with the odds that we're getting, he's gonna bluff here 1-5 times, so it's gonna be fine. But yeah, not already excited about it.
I love that he leads.
And just like that, we're going on break. Yeah, I mean, nice, we shipped the bounty. Yesterday you finished second, so pretty happy that we got the win today. I mean, it's been a long grind for me, 12 hours as of this minute. Definitely a long one. Yeah, fun heads up battle. Nice spot with the sevens. I love my 6-2 play, that worked out perfectly. And now we got this heads still this tournament open. We can go over the hands because I played some hands, certainly not the best here. I was pretty distracted with the heads up, so we'll just blame that. I think ace 9 is like reasonable, but as I said, people are not bluffing that often, so we could find a fold there. Ace 3 is, I think, also fairly reasonable. We can look over it again. He called a c-bet, flop goes check check, and then he bets the river, and he just has like so few better hands that I think the race is fine. Nobody's ever thought we were jamming there, but this guy's a bit crazy, so maybe he's the one person I shouldn't go for value there or against. Ace queen spot I think is also pretty reasonable versus population, but this guy's not population, he's a special guy, and I like that.
Guy, you wanna maybe check back?
I'm not sure, I just saw some punts from him earlier. I'm not sure what those exact punts were. I just saw like spots where he got in for infinite blinds where he shouldn't really look like. But obviously I was too fine tables, so it's only saw it from the, how you say it? The peak of my eye or something. How you say
peripheral?
It? Yeah, peripheral. Yeah. That's a nice word, I like that.
That is a good word. I don't use it enough.
Let's see. Luckily, Germ, yeah, it was fun. We got it in like with ace king versus king. So he was like, oh, some guy open chance 13 BB. I called the big one with ace king. I'm like, that's a really nice spot. Sadly, he has sixes. And luckily, we are German. King.
That's good.
I told my German friend to start running like you. He just won't listen. What an idiot.
Not German enough.
I'm German and running fucking bad. How do you do this? First of all, you're not running bad. You're just terrible at the game. Second of all, just grind more, dude. I played so many tournaments today. I'm just straight up.
You might be a future sub, Henry. Come on.
Yeah. I'm rich enough that I don't need the subs. I'm just here, man. I'm in here to insult people, to make them clear. Like, you're not running bad, dude. You're actually just bad at the game, right? Like, you're obviously running bad to some extent, maybe. But I had some spots there we got 3-0. That shit happens. You just have to fire up shit ton of tournaments, and then in one of them, you're going to have the sun run to win it.
You're absolutely right.
Got told. All right, let's get into that. All Germans are bad in the opinion of other guys. Would it? There's a supreme German. Confirmed. There's a homeless guy in the back of your room. That was before you came, by the way. So I'm not really sure. I'm not even kidding. Like, DD's going to start streaming soon, right? You're only waiting for your mic.
The mic is supposed to come in tomorrow, so I might even do it tomorrow.
Nice.
Grind or something. We'll see.
Nice. I'm not sure if he was a bot, guys, but it's just like sometimes it was a bit quick. How do I get a bot?
it's hard to tell who's a bot, and a lot of time it's up to sample sizes.
Oh, this is 7-10. It's so nice when you just forward jams to 5. It's the dream spot where everybody talks
so
about.
So nice.
It's just clean. Metzger, like the lower the game, the easier it actually is. I'm not sure why people ever think that, but like if you play against me, you're going to get destroyed. If you play against a random guy at 1-2 cent, you're going to find leaks in his game to exploit him, like, really, really hard. The thing is just, like, he might be crazy, but then you just wait for a good hand and call it off, right? It's pretty easy to play against these guys. It's just tough to play against people that are, like, really, really tricky, and that's not really the thing in 1-cent, 2-cent games. So if somebody just plays really crazy, goes on for 100 big blinds, you shouldn't be calling ace-check. Just wait till your face is called it and live the life. Yeah. I agree, as a master. Usually bots always have to, like, the same time bank. But just that he limped so quickly, and it's just odd. How do you even do that?
Yeah, it just sounds like, what's his name again?
Metzger.
Sounds like Butcher. Maybe it might be something, it's probably a big problem on your side. Like, you need to adjust better. You
know? Exactly.
You need to be paying more attention to how your opponents are playing. It's a hyper exploitative game, so if you're not adjusting accordingly to who you're playing, then that's your fault and not anybody else's. Even with the awful rake, it's like the easiest game to beat. You know, you just gotta get your shit together.
Confirmed. All right, let's close this one out, guys. We're not doing that great. We made some really sexy plays earlier. Oh, DD, you're gonna love this one. Wait, I can go away. Let's see. Queen, deuce of clubs. That was some street poker, right? Oh, wait. That was a different queen, deuce of clubs, I guess. Where is it? Alright, I'm gonna try to find this. Oh, yeah, there we go. That was like... So, this is like a hand I really like. I open. 3 bets. Small, so I continue. That's recreational. He comes in with the sizing on the flop. I'm just like, fuck off. And then he fucks off. Street poker, yo!
You got all the back doors too, so fuck that guy.
Yeah.
That's fun.
I won 2.2k total in that one. Okay, that's an argument, yeah. Thanks, Rashina. GG, guys. Wait, didn't I fix the... it's so weird with the new thing. It always takes a while to update.
I haven't looked at it yet. I hear it's really bad, though.
Thanks, guys. All right, we just need a double here. This guy definitely owned me a bit, so... Let's just run hot. I mean, we already cashed $500. Nice profitable day, obviously, with the 2K score. Like, definitely over 4K in cashes today.
How many buy-ins?
I have no idea. Not that much today. No. But, like, we definitely cashed much. Like, I think at least 2K profit today.
Sweet.
That's a good day.
Yeah.
Take it. I would like to see this guy bust here so I can get this additional $170 ladder and then. Yeah, I would agree, KB. I think, like, generally it's just a raise, but, like, if you 3-bet jams on the river, like, as a bluff ever, it's just fucked. I think it's still better to raise, to be honest, because he's just. It's close to impossible for him to have a better hand, given how he played, I think, so.
And it is easy to, like, fold to a jam just because it's, like, almost impossible for him to have a
block. Exactly, yeah. So, actually, like, I still like the play. Maybe it's just unfortunate it, like, ran into a balance check there by, like, King 10 or something. 3, ace, 3, 4 is not queen, right? Yes.
What?
I don't know.
What did you say?
3, ace, 3, 4 is not queen. Is it, though? Are we queen? Who is queen?
What is queen?
What is queen? Dude, I was listening to Queen live at London or something.
Yeah. There's a movie coming out.
Yeah.
It looks,
like,
really good on him.
Yeah, fuck, dude.
Legendary.
That's so sick, man.
Legendary.
Just big, big Queen fan.
Yeah. I don't listen to enough of Queen.
I listen to so much Queen.
I listened to a ton of Queen when I was, like, a teenager, and then I kind of got sick of it.
Yeah. My parents are in the rock choir, and I've been to, like, a concert of them once, and it's just, like, 40 people singing Bohemian Rhapsody in a church. So... It wasn't a church, and the sound was sick. And they're, like, amateur singers, right? Yeah. But they're, like, still really good, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And you just sit there in this church and take it in, and it's just...
That would be pretty
fucking
cool.
Yeah, it's insane, man. It's so nice.
Anything like that in a church would be cool. Just the acoustics are perfect.
Yeah, acoustics are so nice. It's, like, the entire setting. It's just... That's amazing. People don't realize the volume you guys put in. Yeah, exactly. Like, I've been grinding for 12 hours today, 12 tabling most of the time. Like, an average... I mean, now, obviously, the last 3 hours, I played, like, 5-6 tables, but before that, shit ton, so... Yeah.
Yeah, people... that's another thing, too, you guys have to remember, is volume is so important.
Yeah.
Like, whether you're good or bad, like, volume's just so huge.
Yeah, people are playing, like, 200 tournaments a year and expect any results, right? It's just not happening.
Exactly.
200 is what I put in a day.
Or like 10k hands of cash per year or something. Stupid. Yeah. Like, that's just not even close to enough.
Nice, BSC. Oh, Kings, let's go.
Easy peasy. First the punter. Come on.
Just one call or something so I can get in preflop. No. Nope. All right. No ace, please.
Motherfucker.
I'm still going broke here. If I have to. We'll see. Here, 6-7. I'm not going to fold the turn here. I think he's going to have enough bullshit. We'll see what he does, obviously. If he bets a third, I hate my life. That's pretty nice. Can I value jam? I will just block bet. I think value jam is fine, but the problem is if I jam here, I don't think we get call often enough. But if I bet a third, I think he's gonna call like an 8 fairly often.
Just sucks to see him fold like 8-7 or something.
Yeah. The douche 86 was the sub. Thank you very much, dude. Welcome home. That's the first sub of the day. Like, new sub. Thank you, man. Must be nice profit for the day, huh? With these scores. Oh, yeah, I totally forgot about 500 bucks we're gonna cash for here as well. Yeah, definitely. Oops, I'm on the wrong cable again. Sorry for that. I hope you didn't miss the action, guys.
Do you manually keep track of all your profits or?
Nah, Sharkscope.
Just Sharkscope?
Yeah. Have a player group there and then just do it like that. That's some, like some Isildur snap kicking LMR. ship the 55 bounty for 2.2k. Good to see you, peace. The douche with the hype. Oh, yeah, let me get some hype in there for you as well, man. A little bit of Bu Rocket. A little bit of Bu Yaman. Just a bit too rich because we can. Cheers, mate.
You must be at the top of the poker listing, huh?
I have no idea, to be honest. I'm just too inconsistent. I'm not really sure. Like, I mean, good view account. We got a wholesome path. In a cycle, just in life, yeah.
Good time of the day, too.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty late.
Yeah.
GRGL, thanks, mate. All right, we won a little pot with the Kings. Can't complain too much. Always an ace and still winning. I take it.
This is like the coldest room right now.
It is, yeah. Definitely cools off in the evening. Dude, what a long day of grinding, man. I'm going to bed soon again. Because I want to fire up an early session tomorrow so I can play before the WPT main.
Oh, yeah, the main's tomorrow, isn't it?
Good luck. Hold it. 7.
There
that works. Nice. Easy. Let's get it. Four-handed.
Easy.
I should adjust these pails a little bit.
What time is the main tomorrow? Is it in the evening? Or?
Yeah, 6 p.m. or something.
Ah, okay. Yeah. It's a long day for you, but if you're down.
Yeah, I'm in there for the grind, dude. This is... My month has been insane. And like grinding at this time of the day for the first time in like 2.5 years of grinding. It's just, it's mind-blowing.
Put in long days with you.
Yeah.
I'm the opposite. I'm going to be playing less poker so I can study more.
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah. I mean, the sooner in your career you study, the most, the better.
Yeah, for sure. Well, that's a big reason why I came here too, right? Learn off you guys and everything.
Yeah. Sounds good. I like it. I don't know how many binds today. I really don't keep track with that stuff. Just play whatever I think I'm doing good in. I like to look at my sharks group at the end of like the week or whatever, and then they're like, oh, nice. But if I would pay attention to every buy-in of the day and every cash of the day, I think it would affect my mood too much, and I wouldn't be as good if I know, oh, shit, I'm already 2K in the hold, man. This tournament is 1600 up top. Will not even make me profitable for the day. So I'm only guessing. Let's see, run good. One quick bankroll question. How many binds do you suggest for MTTs? I always heard about this 1% of your bankroll buy-in, but I think that's too much. Thanks for answering. No. I would say like 1% is like, it's likely to be too aggressive than too little. So I would just recommend, like, what I used to do, like, if you'd want to, it depends on which position you are in, right? Bankroll management is complicated. If you grind professionally, you should at least have, like, an average buy-in times 200, and that should be your bankroll. So if you have a 10K bankroll, you should play a $50 average buy-in. And that's still like somewhat aggressive, right? So it just depends on which position you're in. If you just want to like grind it up and not be too aggressive, 100 buy-ins seems fine. If you want to be aggressive, then just go with 50 buy-ins. But I wouldn't recommend that. I'm a fan of like slowly grinding it up. Feels the best. And every time somebody like, sorry, every time somebody just thinks one big tournament, they're just usually losing all the money back again because they're just not aware of it. Yeah, it wasn't meant
to be. It was a bad joke. Right,
welcome on my stream. That's good. Greens to DD. Yo, what up?
You.
Danke, Poseidon, man. Said I should be careful with the kiwis. There's rumors they eat people. I mean, like the bird he's talking about. Is there no roof on your house, Henry? Hood up. There is a roof. And it's not on fire. 60 prince, 60 king. I have no idea, man. Two back said like a lot of weird things today that I don't know. Oh shit, he's punting again. Call! Dude, I've seen this guy all in so many times.
Where is he from?
Oh, his name is Brazil 100%, right?
Yeah. Gotta be.
Hello. Wait, we can just eat. Oh, Canada.
Oh, what the
Huh? Canada has some punters as well. Yeah, let's get an always
midnight, an ace in the chat. Wants to go to bed.
Yeah. Why no shove there? You had like 12 bigs with kings. Because I think he has a really wide opening range. So if I regen, we just fold out a lot of hands that we dominate. So if I flat, I can keep those hands in.
What's up, Hairweed?
Hairweed. Hairweed is such a good guy.
Yeah, he's one of the OGs.
Yeah, like definitely no OGs. Nice. What up?
Hello.
How did you do? What happened?
I busted sixth, I think. I just got really short. Got a pretty sick ladder, which is fine with half a big blind. I broke even. I lost $200, I think.
No, you're on the cam, DD. Perhaps in the mix as well, having some cereal.
Yogurt.
Still need to make what is that? Oh, yogurt, okay. I still need to make dinner. I haven't eaten since lunch today.
I'm gonna make a batch of bolognese.
Okay, not bad. We're on the bolognese grind, dude. Fucking best dish ever. I'm gonna teach you something. Alright, let's cook something. I'm gonna look in the kitchen and find something and then put something together. I have some rice and I have some mushrooms. We can maybe mix in a little bit of milk and do like a nice sauce like that, you know?
Like a carbonara.
Yeah, not quite carbonara. But maybe we have some bacon as well. Could get something going there.
What do you win right now?
Big 27. Four-handed. Shipped a 55 PKO for 2.2K. That was nice. Man, I gotta overtake you. I told the people about our little challenge. Trying to win more money this year than the other. And it's fucking close. Like, we're in within like K or so, 2K. I mean, I think like I overtook you now with my 2K score. Yeah. Yeah, so I think I'm 1 or 2K ahead of past profit for the year. So it's a nice little challenge. I motivate to grind. Nobody wants it more. Dude, I was in Germany. I moved to the UK.
I could only play in ACR.
It doesn't count. Like, given how bad you are, it's better for you that you only grind on ACR.
Because you have the option to play on those sites that I could play on as well. I didn't.
The option. You could always move somewhere else. Just shut up already.
You can say that as well. That's true.
If you say this, I can only count my like 20k life score.
You cannot count life score.
it's so annoying that he overbets here. Did Henry win both MTTs yet? We won the first one. 18 BB on the second. Just chilling. The thing is like... Whatever. I don't know. Could call. DD has only been here for like a week now or something.
Yeah, I'm moving out. I don't like it here. These guys are really annoying.
DD is like our own. Like through DD, we know some of his family now. They're pretty good people. So we're a bit more social. There was we had a visitor once. Actually, two different
my cousin
visitors.
And my uncle.
Yeah.
Yeah, my cousin's.
Yeah, guy. I love your cousin.
He's good people. Smart kid. Good guy.
We should mess up. Rameth drops a 5-month resub. PokeChamp. Appreciate it, even though I haven't been streaming much lately, dude. Welcome back home. I'm not sure why there's no sound for you. Trigger.
Yeah, I was nervous about whether or not we'd all get along, but it's actually been pretty... Well, you never know, right? Like, I know you guys, but you never know, right?
Yeah, but, like, we're pretty honest with each other on Skype.
I feel like we know each other for, like, over 2 years now, right? Yeah.
I definitely had that inkling. You really never know. You really never know. Like,
just because it would be so bad if we didn't like each other. Like, yeah. It'd be the worst 6 months.
I've had experiences of moving in with people that were like legitimately my friends that I had known for a while, and it like was a nightmare. So I was like, fuck. But it's worked out really well.
I mean, we've been only here for a month now, so we'll see in like 3 months. You know. Once the house.
Well, it helps that it's a big house. Ooh. And we all have our own personal space and shit.
Oh, yeah. No. So we limp 18 big blinds with the ace to suit it because I don't really want to raise fold. And that's a pretty good flop. Just going to start with a check, though.
The nut nut with the redraw to the nut nut.
It's a pretty bad turn, but maybe it's a good turn. We never know. I'm just going to fire 70% and then go for like a check on the river.
Black 4.
I don't want to see a black 4. Well, they didn't have a spade, I guess. First time I see on from New Zealand. I've been streaming for like the last 2 days as well. But
hey, like 1.6k or something for first?
Yeah, 1.619. Yeah. I streamed some like doing scoop and scoop, but yeah. Haven't streamed that much just because I've been grinding heaps. Cheers, lost that. Slothality. Wow, it's a tough name. Slothality. Yeah, I mean, usually I'm not on at this time of the day, dude. I started my grind 12 hours ago. It's been a long day for me. Yeah, it is winter. It's still warmer than
UK. You know, when I watched your streams in the wintertime for you, and you're like always putting on a sweater, I was like, you're being a little bitch, you know?
Well, for here.
Yeah, well, back in Australia. Yeah. And now that I'm experiencing winter, yeah, it's actually kind of cold over here in the wintertime.
That's not that bad.
Yeah.
Well, Henry's got it the worst because he doesn't have heated flooring here.
Yeah.
Over there, it's heated, so...
Yeah, my room is cold as fuck up until like 3 p.m.
My room too.
Last night with these pants on, and I love it. Yeah. I never sleep with pants on, but like that's how cold it is.
I wake up in the morning and I instantly put on 2 sweaters.
Wow, you guys are insane.
Yeah, wow.
I know, I just put on pants and then get a coffee and then I get upstairs, take a shower, and then I'm just... It gets really warm throughout the day as well. Okay, he's back in it.
You gotta remember, you get once that sunlight comes in, that it brings in so much good heat. Oh.
Yeah, he's just aggressive. I have no idea what
he actually
was.
He just re-raises non-stop. Yeah, he's just in there. Turner River.
16 BB. Oh, let's try it.
Here comes Spike with the ISO raise.
Maybe I should even just fold given that they have 1925. Like, I see him's pretty fucked and he's been pretty active. But then people miss play against limbs. I don't know. I definitely like limping more than raising. And I like folding more than raising as well. So it's either limp or fold. Yeah, I'm just gonna check back the flop here, right? It's not a spot where I want to bet fold. It's not a board texture where you see check jams, not that infrequently. So I'm just gonna try to hit my 10 or 5.
One time, where's the 5?
It's actually not that bad of a turn. If they check it to me, I'm gonna bluff. They just have like the big blind has 10 deuce of clubs here and shit like that, right? So many random hands that just fold out. Same comes for the small blind, like queen, 4 of diamonds, all of that shit. So I'm going for the late bluff. Interesting river now. Chuffing it up with other hands like check 10 or that he might occasionally call, but yeah, I was the lead. I'm just letting it go.
Turn size,
yeah, I have an 8 or nothing. Mm. Or like a king, because he doesn't really have the king, right?
Yeah.
I feel like we bet any barrel on that turn, any 9, any king, right?
No, 9.
You wouldn't want to barrel 9 on that turn?
No. Okay. Let's call it. And good luck. I mean, he almost has 90 BBs, but he's been somewhat active. I hope you see a specific sizing. Yeah, this is just fun enough. Good luck, guys.
Oh, come 9 on now.
9? Yeah. I mean, you almost have 19 BB. I think it's fine. Not much you can do there in the end. Yeah, 4th base for 660. Ship the other one for 2.2. Not a bad day. I'm going to be back to crying tomorrow. Not sure if I stream. As I said, my plan for New Zealand streaming is... I'm just firing up a session. If I run deep and have fewer tables, I fire up a stream just as I did today. So you guys see only the nice and deep runs for lots of money.